Hello everyone, I am Chilbi and welcome to my beehive. So in today's video, I am going to show you guys how I created this beautiful makeup look which you all wanted. But first, let's just clip our hair away from our face so that we are good to go. To start, I am using my favorite Blue Heaven primer. You just need to take a tiny bit amount and it goes a long way. I am applying it on my most textured area like my acne scars and bumps and then pressing it gently in my skin. Now, with the help of this damp Miniso Beauty Blender, I am going to apply my Maybelline Fit Me Matte Plus Poreless Foundation, which is in the shade 230. Now, you guys can see how much I love this foundation. It was such a huge task to get this out, but I managed somehow. Now, I'm just dabbing my sponge on my skin, and I love how beautifully this blender blended my foundation. It made it so even and gave a nice coverage. It made my base look flawless, which is all I want while doing my makeup. Now, while blending on your forehead, try to blend the foundation into your hairline for a very seamless effect. After that, I am applying my Swiss Beauty Liquid Concealer in the shade 03 and applying it on my acne scars and the dark spots that I have. Also under my eyes because we want bright eyes. Don't forget the bridge of our nose, on the chin and on the forehead too. Now with the tip of the Miniso blender, I am going to blend everything seamlessly like we did to our foundation with super light dabbing motions. Now I know I look very funny, but to blend your under eyes, you need to make this face so that your concealer doesn't crease. You can also stretch out your skin a little bit so it's flat and even like I'm showing you guys and making it blend easily. After that, I'm using my Maybelline Fit Me Compact in the shade 112 and applying it with F014 brush from the Cuffs and Lashes. Taking the product, dusting the axis, I'm applying the powder in a very gentle circular motion, applying a nice layer under your eyes to set your concealer perfectly. Now for contour and blush, I'm using this gorgeous Sugar Face palette in the shade 02 Vivid Victory. It contains a blush, a highlight and a contour shade, making it perfect and affordable for beginners. I'm using this angled contour brush, which is F012 from Cuffs and Lashes, and picking up the brown shade, dusting the axis and applying it under my cheekbones. This shade is not super duper pigmented, so you need to work on it, which in my opinion is really good. I like to then blend it upwards to just give it a natural finish. Can you see the difference? Now doing the same exact thing on the other side too, I'm just placing the product right under my cheekbone to give that more structure and depth, blending it in an upward direction. Now I'm taking the same fluffy brush and picking the blush generously, dusting off the excess and placing it right on my cheeks. Blend it nicely in an upward motion to get nice rosy cheeks. Wow, I'm clearly obsessed with myself. Now it's time for our eyebrows, and for that I'm using the Sugar Pencil in the shade 03 Woody Scooby. First we need to brush our brows so that we know where the gaps are and where we have to fill in our brows. Now by using the retractable pencil, I'm filling it in, making light hair-like strokes. Don't go all in and start very lightly. Also choose a lighter shade for your eyebrows because it will look very evident if you choose a darker shade like black. So I always choose a brown shade as it matches my brows perfectly. Brush them again to blend everything smoothly. Now using the Swiss Beauty Makeup Fixer, I am going to lock my base in. You need to shake this well and first spray it in air just to see if it's coming out properly or not. Now spray it all over your face, holding your hair behind and let it air dry. Now I'm taking E001, which is a small fan brush. I'm going to take the shimmery highlighter from the same Sugar palette and placing it right on top of my cheekbones, blending it very nicely. Also under my brow bone, on the tip of the nose and also on the bridge of my nose as well as on the upper lips. After that, I'm using my Dot & Key lip balm to just prep my lips and keep them moisturized. Now coming to eyes, I will be using Nikake Eyeshadow Palette in the shade Autumn Spice. It is perfect palette for both daytime and nighttime looks. Now taking a blending brush, I am taking a very light peach shade and applying it all over my eyelids, focusing on my crease line. Blend it very nicely so that you have a nice base to start with. Now I am taking this mustard yellow shade and blending it on and above my crease line. In any eyeshadow look, you have to start with lighter shades and use darker shades afterwards. Now using another blending brush, which is E007 from Cuffs and Lashes, I am taking this bright orange shade and packing it into my crease line. Blend it using wind wiper motions. This palette is nicely pigmented and all the shades are smooth to work with. You will need to blend the orange and yellow shade together using the brush lightly. I am also applying the orange shade on my eyelids, leaving the inner part of my eyes. And now you just need to blend. Now with the previous brush which still had some yellow pigment, I am going to blend the orange shade which is above my crease, giving it a nice gradient look. Now I'm taking this deep brown shade on a small blending brush and packing it on the outer corner of my eyelids and blending it lightly into my crease. Taking this peachy shimmer shade and applying it right on the inner part of my eyelids. Shimmers really do enhance every look and I love working with them. Now I'm taking this golden shimmer shade which is blinding. Placing this on top of the peachy shade we just put and blending it with my fingers only. Now I'm mixing the deep orange and the brown shades together to smoke out my lower lash line. It's finally time for eyeliner and for that I'm using Maybelline Colossal Bold Liner. Start by applying thin lines right above your lash line. Work slowly and steadily. Now extend a thin line from the outer corner of your eye to make a wing. Join the end to your lash line and fill all the gaps in. Don't forget the inner corners too. And I'm done with my liner. I also added little triangles on my inner corner to get those foxy eyes. It's the time for mascara, ta-na-na-na-na. And for that, I'm using Maybelline Hyper Curl Easy Wash Mascara. Always remember to take out the excess product from the wand so that your lashes don't stick together. Now you just need to brush your lashes upwards like this. Do the same with your lower lash line, but with very light hands. And we are here on our final step, which is lipstick. And for that, I am using this beautiful velvet matte liquid lipstick from Miniso. It is such a nice red shade and this doesn't even dry your lips at all. And with that, I am done with this look. I hope you guys enjoyed watching this video and if you did, then do like and share this video. Also hit the subscribe button to see more such videos. I'll meet you next time with another video. Till then, stay safe, stay home and bye. I love you all.